Okay, this is the stream that I'm having the stormwater problems with. We have plenty of channels that seem to be draining down here from the city. I'm unable to get the stormwater drain maps. The DEP has some issues with all the water that's flowing down here. They will be coming here for the meeting. The city manager was here, and he said that, I'll read the email later, but he said that there was really not severe erosion here, that I was kind of like going overboard with it. And he said, according to the contour, this looks normal. So I have taped out the contour here, how the path ran. This was the contour last year, as of June 28, 2010. And this is the width, and I have the height. So as we go along, you look, that was the height, the soil. We were level here on ground, water coming down, okay? Right here is one of the culverts that has been dug out that the city claims that they have not done anything to divert any storm water into this drain. And this culvert clearly shows massive erosion here from all the water coming down. Rocks are I packed into there to stop the trees from coming down. I tried to do as much as I could before I found out that this is DEP regulated. Are we okay? Okay, so we're just gonna walk along the stream here, and it's a little treacherous. The camera will be a little shaky, but I wanna focus in on, you know, you gotta picture this. This was the soil, like almost here. This is where it was level, going up to this tree. We have all these roots exposed all the way down. You can clearly see. I mean, it may have went up a little bit higher here. Well, not really, because this water was cresting over here this winter. It was like wild rapids coming down here. This is a natural stream, and it's clearly been dug out with heavy equipment as well. So there's a lot of questionable things around here. Okay, so more erosion. This is my yard here. So last year, this property here came out to here. I easily was coming down here with a mower. I can't even get down here with a mower anymore. All this is crumbling in. Every time it rains, it crumbles down more. Here's the contour again. You can see the land here and over here. So this is where the stream was last year. Coming all the way down, more erosion. And this water in here is just from a rainfall that we had yesterday. Last week, this stream was bone dry. So yesterday we had rain for, I don't know, a few hours. And I'd say there's probably 2 to 3 inches of water in here right now. You could check that on the rain charts. The city of Belfast has the amount of rainfall that would have fallen yesterday, so you can determine how much rain comes down here when there's a heavy snow and heavy rain throughout the season. Because this is the first rain that we've had in months, over, probably the whole month of August, I think, at least. So. And July was pretty dry too. So here we are again. All this is eroded. All these roots are exposed. Again, the property line was right there. So yeah, Joe, this is the contour, and this is not serious, right? And here we go, coming down some more. We're almost at the end here. All these things are ready to fall in. This is where it gets a little bit deeper. Again, as we're going down a little bit, the soil drops down the contour. So all that was lost within 6 months. This property belongs to the mental health. Okay, here we go. All this over here. What's really getting crazy is right over there is on the corner of my fence. You can clearly see how much property I've lost over there. This was all even all the way out. So, I mean, it'll be gone in a matter of months. I keep putting a tarp over it now every time it rains to save it from falling in. Look. I know Mike Hogan, the town architect, had said during last winter that culvert was flooded right up to the road. The water almost went over the road and over into the hospital. He said luckily it didn't flood. Apparently this water goes down through a chamber underneath the hospital, and the hospital must have that chamber wide open to accommodate this water. And it was full throttle, making this like torrent, wild rapids. It was unbelievable. Here's some more here. Erosion, there's trees hanging out. Oh, that was the water went right up to that tree over there. Those roots are now all exposed on the one side. I thought it might be in danger of coming down, but you know, we've got three more sides to erode away before before that happens. And we're almost done here. All this, I packed rocks in to stop all these from falling in and underneath here. And then you can clearly see over here, as you go down, there's two more yards down there. And there's two more yards that go down there, and then you hit the culvert in Northford Avenue. All these roots are like this all the way down, exposed, all hanging, all the way down the rest of the pattern. And when Joe came here, he immediately just came to this area and down to the next two lots, made his decision, and said it wasn't too serious. So after we've taken all this, I would like to read to you his summary of what he felt was the review of this erosion here. And here I wanted to just show one of the culverts that are along this road that I have been told for the past 3 months that the city did not do, that they haven't had any hand in doing any stormwater diversion. Clearly you can see that culvert coming in across the street, and that I know for a fact was done in the 90s. So this is where it pours down into the creek, and that's where one of the trees is that I had to put a whole bunch of rocks underneath because of the volume of the water that comes pouring down through here. And then I'm going to take you over to the other side of the yard to show you that culvert. And almost all the yards on this side have these culverts. So, and the city did dig them out. Okay? And this is the culvert on the other side of my yard that actually at one time this was just one whole lot. So certainly the people that owned this before didn't have this culvert running through the middle of their yard. I bought this house last year on June 28th, so I think this was done probably in the 90s or so as well. And that also runs all the way down to the end, and that's where we started off this tour that showed you all the rocks over there. So right now I'm going to read you the findings of the city manager when he came just to inspect this stream. I'm taking your concern seriously, but unfortunately it is not the only concern that I have to address right now. Mind you, I've been at this since May, and today is August 17th, I believe. I am taking the liberty of sharing this email with Belfast City Council. I spent over an hour at your house Tuesday and walked the stream and listened to every concern you have raised. I see no sign of imminent danger to your property, and as such, I cannot justify treating this matter as though it was an emergency and push my other responsibilities to the side. The stream itself is about 4 feet deep and about 8 feet wide and was essentially dry. It has the same shape and level of erosion along its bank at every point where I observed it. It is essentially dry, and I saw one inch puddle in a 100-foot walk that I took through it. You identify no damage or threat to your house, but you are very upset by the erosion in your backyard. I saw this erosion, and while there is some there, the scale and scope of it was far smaller than I imagined from reading your emails. You have raised multiple concerns, and it is very clear that you are extremely focused and upset by both the erosion situation itself, as well as the treatment you feel that you have had at the hands of the city in responding to your concerns. Your letter today is indicative of your anxiety and expectation of immediate need for answers. Immediate from May. Okay, sure. Immediate need for answers, which is not consistent with what I had told you on Tuesday. I advised you that I was going to look into this and that it would take some time. I told you that I would attempt to summarize your concerns in the next day or so. That is, I was going to make sure I had a complete list of your questions and concern. I never said I would resolve all of your issues in a day. I never asked you to resolve all of the issues. I asked you to tell me what you thought about the stream. That was all. I never said I would resolve all your issues in a day and a half. I said I would get back to you, and I am sorry if 48 hours is worse for you than 36 hours. And then you go on and on too, but that's just about the brunt of it. So for now, I'm going to end this DVD. I wanted to get this going in case there's rain or more water in the stream. So when this meeting finally does take place on August 24th, we can refer to this for all the erosion and damages. Thank you for your time.